journey of an oil and gas well begins long before a well is drilled. It starts with exploration. This phase involves searching for potential commercial accumulation of oil and gas deposits, which usually begins with geological surveys. This process incorporates the use of seismic data to create maps of underground rock formations. Seismic waves are generated at or near the surface of the Earth using a seismic source, for example, dynamite, hammer, vibrator, air gun, water gun, or anything that will transmit energy into the subsurface. The seismic waves propagate from the source and travel through geologic layers. At the interface between one type of rock and another, there is a change in physical properties, causing some seismic waves to reflect back to the surface, while the other waves refract and further transfer to the next interface. At the surface, seismic receivers called geophones or hydrophones detect the reflected energy and convert it into electrical signals. The signals are recorded and later processed into images of the underground geology. If these images show promising results, it will be accepted to proceed with drilling to confirm the presence of hydrocarbons. The drilling phase involves using a drilling rig to drill a well into the earth. Drillers use a rotating drill bit to penetrate the rock layers and a drilling fluid to help keep the well stable and lift the drilling cuttings to the surface. As the well reaches the target depth, casing is installed to prevent the well from collapsing and to protect groundwater. With the well drilled and cased, it is time to move into the third phase, the completion phase. It involves preparing the well for the efficient extraction of hydrocarbons. This phase includes several key processes. Number 1. Wellbore cleanup. The well is cleaned of any debris, drilling fluids, or other materials that might obstruct the flow of hydrocarbons. Number 2. Perforation. In conventional wells, perforation involves creating small holes in the casing and cement, typically in the reservoir zone, to allow oil or gas to flow into the wellbore. This is usually done using a perforating gun. Number 3. Installation of completion equipment. Various equipment is installed to control the flow of hydrocarbons and facilitate production. This includes tubing, packers, and other flow control devices. Number 4. Stimulation. In some wells, especially those in unconventional reservoirs like shale, stimulation techniques such as hydraulic fracturing or acidizing are used to increase the permeability of formation, thereby enhancing hydrocarbon flow. Number 5. Testing. The well is often tested to evaluate its potential production rate and to gather data on the reservoir. Number 6. Hookup installation. The final step involves installing surface equipment such as wellheads and flow lines to manage the flow of oil or gas from the well to processing facilities. Once these steps are completed, the well is considered completed and is ready to begin production, which is the fourth phase. Production involves installing equipment to separate oil, gas, and water. Oil and gas are then transported through pipelines or other methods to refineries or processing plants. During this phase, the well will be monitored closely to manage production rates and ensure safe operations. If any problem is encountered, workover and well intervention operations will be essential to overcome such problems and restore the well productivity. A workover is a major operation involving significant intervention in a well. It often requires bringing in a workover rig and can involve extensive procedures like pulling and replacing tubing, repairing or replacing downhole equipment, or even recompleting the well in a different zone. On the other hand, well intervention refers to any operation carried out on a live producing well to maintain or improve its performance. These operations are usually less invasive than workovers, as they neither require a full rig nor killing the well. Instead, they require simpler means such as slick line, electric line, and coil tubing. Eventually, every well reaches the end of its productive life. This is when the final phase begins. This phase is called P&A, which is short for plug and abandon. It involves safely shutting down the well, removing equipment, and restoring the site to its natural state. The well is plugged with cement to prevent any leaks between different zones or leaks to the external environment. And that's a wrap on the life cycle of an oil and gas well, from exploration to P&A. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more content on the oil and gas industry. Thank you for watching, and see you next time on PetroLearn.